Hi everyone, today I'm super happy to be in the workshop because I'm going to design an upgrade for the conveyor belt, and this project gives me the chance to use everything I've learned the recent years and nail this design first try. I'm using my 5-point star to get mechanics, timing, audio, usability and looks right for this design to keep both the artist and the engineer happy. For the conveyor upgrade, I'm gonna follow a strict design process. I'm gonna start with analyzing the old design, what actually went wrong. Then I'm going to specify the new design, what needs to go absolutely right with the new design. After that, I will start designing in CAD, program the tool paths to CNC manufacturing, assemble on Marmachine X, and lastly, test the part and finish up. The first and absolutely critical issue is that the conveyor belt is producing ghost marbles. So I've seen that there are instances where marbles get stuck here. I'm going to crank the machine and look what happens with these marbles. These ghost marbles travel down the conveyor belt on the backside row and get released here underneath, super close to the gears. They can go straight into the gears and break the whole Marble Machine X. And in several marble tests, I all of a sudden found marbles on the floor that I had no clue where they came from. So when I discovered this, I was kind of happy because it's a perfect explanation. I think all the ghost marbles have come from this conveyor belt critical failure. The next issue is that the marbles make a huge sound when they're being dropped off. I tried to fix the audio issue by adding silicone here, which dampened the sound, but I think it was the silicone that caused marbles to get stuck here, leading to the critical failure. So that's a great example of a design that it's not free from moles. So I whacked down one mole, the audio issue, and up I create another mole, the critical failure issue. So that's why I'm so excited today with a new chance to make a mole-free design, not playing whack-a-mole engineering on this part anymore. Next issue was a mechanical failure where the marble escaped this back wall. So I added as an afterthought this wall and later also this tape. On the new design, I definitely don't want to whack-a-mole like that. The next issue is this brittle acrylic material. When I put screws into it, it cracks and it's not nice to work with. I cracked it in several places here and it doesn't feel good. The next issue is these two forks down here. Asking the marbles to fork into one pipe is asking for trouble. I thought I was super smart because I thought the tightest turn would come first. So 1, 2, 3, 4 would automatically create 1, 2, 3, 4 into the pipe. It kind of works when I drop them like this. Check this out. Same thing on the big channel here. In theory, this is a beautiful design. Only problem, chaos and entropy reigns up here. When the marbles bump into each other, we're not sure they're gonna flare out in that nice 1, 2, 3, 4 order, which means that we have the theoretical possibility of two marbles coming here and just not negotiating the space. The next issue is that it's not visually really super impressive. When I designed this, I thought it would look so nice on camera, seeing this flaring out and then in there. In reality, it goes so fast. On video, you can't really perceive what is happening. You don't see which marble comes from where and where it's going. So the visual aspect can be heavily improved. And the last issue is that the marble divider entry control system is not working. So the idea was that I could put a thing here that kicked out the marble into the marble divider at that spot. So this could be kind of important if the vibraphone plays a lot of notes down here. Maybe we want the marbles to enter earlier, more to this side in the marble rider. So the parts I want to replace in this new design is this, these two pipes, and this. I want to build a connection from here that flows more beautifully all the way down here. And I have a super cool idea for how to do this. I found so many issues, so they hardly fit on my notepad. I want to add a bonus engineering issue, which is black, and that is many parts. I think I can reduce the part count a lot in my new design. Specify requirements. I've written down what I want the new design to do. Less than 1 of 1 million marbles are allowed to fail, escape, or get stuck. This is a red requirement, which means it's strict. It cannot be negotiated or compromised. The second red requirement is that the design should be solid, sturdy, and anti-brittle. That's also non-negotiable. We want low marble noise, we would like to use few parts, we want it to look great, and we would like some divider entry control. All these other color requirements are optional, we can compromise with them, it would be nice to have. I caught myself thinking, this is way overkill, Martin, and then I was like, it's actually not. So the Marble Machine X is complicated, and the method I have tried and used for all these years is me thinking I need that part and just starting to make it, and later mole infestation. Spending all this time up front thinking about what is this part actually, what is non-negotiable in the end when this part is on the machine, that will just save so much time in the long run. So go slowly in the beginning, do the preparation correctly, and the making and the assembling will just fit like a jigsaw puzzle. I think that's engineering. In the old design, I used 4 plywood parts, 5 metal parts, 5 acrylic parts, and 40 pieces of hardware for a total parts count of 54 parts. And for processes, I did CNCing of the plywood, CNCing of acrylic, welding, drilling, tapping of the metal, and manual bending of the PMMA pipes for a total of 6 processes. This is inefficient. I think my new design can be 10 times more efficient. When this project is at its most fun, it's when I feel like someone discovering uncharted territory. I'm like sensing the opportunity of making an amazing design, but it's not there yet, and it's a lot to discover in this little mini adventure that we're embarking on together right now. Designing from first principles. So first principles thinking is boiling down things to the most essential truth and reason up from there, as opposed to reason by analogy. We used to do it like this, so that's how we do it. So from first principles, we need to transport the marbles from here to here. So point A to point B. So my first step is to map point A and point B from the real physical world to the digital computer. So I will start with these 4 holes, and I will use this as an origin point for the CAD design. So now I'm gonna create the origin point for the whole project. So I'm creating the first sketch on an origin plane. I'm going to position the first hole on the origin point. So we need 4 holes, and I'm just putting them out like this. And now I'm going to show you the power of constraints. I want this center to be vertical with this, this to be vertical with this. I want this to be horizontal with that. I want this to be horizontal with that. That's our 4 holes. Now we need to know the distance between them. So I'm heading over to the old part, and I'm measuring that. 14 millimeter. 146 millimeter. So we're gonna add a dimension constraint. This is 14, this is 146. So now I'm choosing the equal constraint, and I'm saying this circle is equal to this, this circle is equal to this, this circle is equal to this. So now I can add one dimension on one circle to change the hole size for all 4. We're using M5 bolts, but I want the position to be adjustable. So I'm gonna go with an oversized hole. Pretty big, maybe 8. The next step is the contour of the part. And to help with that, I'm gonna make a cardboard map. So now I want to decide the distance from the moving acrylic conveyor belt to the plywood part coming here. If I make it too big, a marble can fall through. If I make it too small, the conveyor belt can catch on it. So we need to stay clear from the conveyor belt. So if we make the gap less than 8, the center of the marble can never enter the gap. So originally I thought I wanted to do 5 millimeter, but this first principle thinking have helped me to realize I can actually do 7 without a problem, which gives us more clearance to the moving parts. Great. So now I can transfer the marble shuttle outlets. I know exactly where the marble are coming out. I have all this in CAD, but taking the measurements from the real world eliminates any assembling error we made. So I'm removing all inaccuracies by taking new measurements. So now I can use the scan of my cardboard and sync it up to the holes. So now I can use my cardboard template to put out some temporary contours. And then I'm going to ask the arcs to be tangential. See how that line there end up perfect. And now I can make these arcs to be identical by connecting the two points. I make that a construction line. Then I constrain the middle point of the arcs to the middle point of this construction line. And this point to the middle point, boom, they're black, which means they're constrained. Hit S, and then I hit F, and I have a shortcut to the sketch fillet, and I put a fillet there, and I'm happy with 2 millimeters. This will leave no need for sanding. DFM, everyone. I'm having so much fun with this. Woo! Let's hide the canvas, and this is a snapshot of where we are right now. So next I'm going to the conveyor belt here, and I'm going to get one of these shuttles and import it into my new design. So now I'm going to line this marble carrier up with the lines I made. This should come pretty close, you know? Have a look at that. My cardboard lines and the CAD likes each other. Hängslen och livrem, som vi säger på svenska. I feel like Hikaru Nakamura now. Peter Lecco talked wrestling on Tata Steel yesterday. That was so brilliant. Peter Lecco knows everything about handball, wrestling and chess. So here's an important tip. So I want to project some geometries from this marble shuttle to my master sketch. So I'm choosing the lines I want to project here. I'm deselecting projection link because I don't want anything linked to this design in my clean fusion file. The information I want from the marble shuttle is the middle of the marble path, like that. And then I want to check again. 16.159. I remember that number. And then I can just take this sketch line and create a rectangular pattern and say that I want 8 instances of 16.159. Merci. So these sketch lines are now not linked to this model. So if I want to delete the marble shuttles, I can do that with nothing breaking. These lines are still blue. I think we have to constrain them vertically. Yes. Okay, so I'm happy with this. So the marbles need to go from point A to point B. I'm now happy with the mapping out of point A, and I'm going to start to map out point B. This is the theoretical place for the marble divider anyway. We're gonna double check in the real world soon. So the fastest way for me to double check this is just to measure this corner to the center of this hole. 264. Then I'm taking the other back corner to the same hole. 915. First measurement is 274. That's actually 1 centimeter off. Or like on the millimeter, 915 down there in the corner. Okay, cool. When adding this in CAD, I want to talk again about timeline cleanliness. This is exactly what I would have wanted to hear when I started the design in Fusion 360. Maybe it's a little bit in depth for some of you who are not using Fusion 360, but bear with me because this would have been golden information for me to have in the beginning. So these are the important step files, and I want my CAD file to be built up with no references to them. To me, that is very important. So how do I do that? With planes and sketches. Okay, let's go. So the easiest way to create a plane here on the side of the top of the marble divider would be to choose an offset plane and just place it on that surface. Boom, done. However, that plane is now linked to our design. So look at what happened if I delete the marble divider. This feature is referenced by other features in the timeline, Are you sure you want to delete? Okay. What happened to the timeline? Yellow. Yellow is bad. In some cases we want this dependency. In this case, I really do not want this dependency. So let's do it another way. So I want to take a reference that I want to keep forever in my design. For example, the origin planes. Let's measure from this origin plane up here to the side of the marble divider. It says 820. So we get a distance 820. We copy that distance. And now I'm making a plane. But instead of using the side of the marble divider as original reference, I'm using my origin and I'm just pasting our value 820. So this little beautiful plane is now where I wanted the plane, but it's independent from the marble divider design. I'm creating a sketch on my newly created plane. On this independent sketch, I'm projecting these two corners with no projection link. Boom. Now we have 2 points. And they are independent from the marble divider design. They are our own. We own them. So we have extracted the exact position of the marble divider without the annoying references and links to it. Sometimes you want the links, sometimes you don't, but it's important to choose. That will make your timelines so much cleaner, kids. So here's our point A and point B, and all of our reference geometry, all this can be deleted. And as you can see, nothing broke in the timeline. We're all good. So now it's time to start connecting the dots. We need the marbles go from A to B. So from point A down to point B, I need to make a twisted design. And to go between planar and twisted, I'm gonna make a template in cardboard. So these are my Diresta roots. I've been watching a lot of Jimmy Diresta, and this kind of, to be able to both CAD and to be in the physical realm, I think it's good for a maker. Beautiful. Before I can finish the cardboard template, I want to fix this edge here because this is the part we removed. The marbles were behaving really nice when they had this double wall here. So they could kind of use this space to agree which marble comes first and second when they're rolling through the marble divider. So the next step will be to cut a new part like this on the CNC machine. So here is the very simple part. It has some holes from the top for screws, and you can see that the side has a little slant. So let's see how this speed cutting went. Actually, this fits perfect. I love how this looks. This feels great. So, when the marbles enter, they have kind of this plane here to negotiate each other. That really works great. So now when we have this part on, I can go back to working on the cardboard template. If you remember the original machine, it had a very characteristic flare on the top of the machine. And I think I'm going to be able to do something super curvy and super visual here. We have to post this video very soon, so I'll continue with this tomorrow. And even though you haven't really seen me starting on the lines, the marble paths themselves, I have done more today than what you think. I think this idea of designing from first principles is just very, very fun. And it allows me to combine the engineer and the artist, hopefully. Hype is super high. It will always be beaten down by the next failure. And that's the roller coaster that is the Marble TNX. Really lovely to have you with me here in the workshop. See you tomorrow for the continuation of this.